Hello, and welcome to the Chilliwack Community's Concert Band very special Remembrance Day show in collaboration with Chilliwack's Philomusica Chorus. I'm Kevin Biegel.
And I'm Paula Quick. And together, we'd like to present to you a collection of pieces performed by the Chilliwack Community Concert Band and Philomusica Chorus to our special live audience in the atrium of the beautiful Sardis Secondary School.
Remembrance Day is a special time to reflect on all those who have dedicated their lives so that we may live prosperous and happy in the true North, strong and free.
Amen. Canada is regularly nominated as the best place in the world to live. And we should remember the sacrifices of the courageous servicemen and women and their families.
Also, while you enjoy the music,
please sit back, reflect, and remember.
Welcome these guys. First of all, I'd like to acknowledge that we are playing, enjoying, working on the traditional Nunseek territory of the Sulu people. So we're very grateful to be able to do this concert this evening. I'm very honored to have Paula Quick join me. It was something I never thought would happen in my lifetime. I always thought of myself as a student under her. So this is a real privilege for myself. So thank you, and thank you
very much. Oh, it's my pleasure. I'd also like to say thank you for coming out every month, and welcome. And we are so excited about live music this evening, and to be able to share it with the band and produce the chorus together is like a dream come true for us. But apart from that, I have one small item that I must look after before we start.
I don't have perfect pitch, so definitely not. Okay, would you please stand with us? We're going to sing our national anthem together. They make me very proud. The first time I heard Edelweiss was actually around our kitchen table. As a young boy, I heard it and I thought, wow, this melody, it is beautiful. But it was a blessing. It was asking, you know, bless our friends, bless our food, come, dear Lord, and sit with us. I was wowed by it. But then I didn't actually listen to the musical, the sound of music, until my early 20s. In fact, I was working on a bachelor of music, and the teacher said in one of the tests given, what is this music? And, you know, we're going to get 5 points. And it was The Hills Are Alive with The Sound of Music. And I hadn't heard the musical at all. So I didn't know that. And I just couldn't believe it. And then I listened to the music, The Sound of Music. I was so just in awe of the music. It was such a wonderful thing. I got, my family today, they enjoy music because of the inspiration of that musical. We're going to do Edelweiss for you. I hope you appreciate it as much as I love this music. James Swearingen is probably one of my favorite composers. He's an American, and he is schooling in Ohio. Very prolific. He's has over 600 pieces to his name, and I enjoy his compositions very much and have here at the high school. This piece is Proud Spirit. Thank you.
Experience. I certainly learned a whole lot about film editing, etc., etc. But it lacked, you cannot duplicate the in-person music that we have this wonderful opportunity to present to you. For the next two pieces, I made some selections of, based on not only my personal likes, but also, am I loud enough? Not only on my I made the selections based on not only my personal likes, but also I made choices that I thought would reflect some of the thoughts that are in our minds at this time of the year. The first piece that I'm going to conduct with the choir is from the film Passchendaele, and it's entitled After the War. And the Passchendaele, the film, was made in honor of the Canadian contribution to the retaking of the village Passchendaele in Belgium during World War I. And I have been told that after the Canucks, they were called Canucks then, but after the Canadians took that back from the Germans, that the Canadians were considered the tough guys. And so, therefore, evermore, the Canadians and the Canadian Armed Forces have been known not to take too many prisoners. So, Passchendaele was a film that was made to commemorate and honor the casualties in 1917. The second piece that I chose was a one that I thought would bring your spirits up, and at the same time reflect the honoring of passing. And the text of the We Rise Again, which is the second piece, speaks of encouragement to accept life's cycle and enjoy your grandchildren as I am these days. So, after the war, and I should not forget to mention that I have, for after the war, I have a lovely little combo that's going to accompany us. Of course, the wonderful Jennifer Silva on piano. If you look up in the corner there, you will see a lady who looks quite a bit like me. That is Margaret Smiley, my twin sister, and she will be playing oboe. Beside her is Sarah Dick, wonderful flautist, and I dragged at the last minute Zach Lang in to play clarinet for obligato with us. And although not too well this week, Sarah Wilson on the string bass will also be playing with us. So please enjoy, and let me know if I ramble. Please enjoy After the War from Passchendaele.
I failed to mention that we had a lovely soprano soloist there. That was Cynthia Rose. And thank you. We're on to rounds again.
Hi.
This next piece that we're going to do is Novena. Novena is actually a prayer, and it's an extended prayer. In fact, the very first Novena took place between the ascension of Christ and then Pentecost, the outpouring of the Spirit. And when you look at it, there's a period of 9 days. So that was the first Novena. And so Novena has to do with extended prayer. And that's what this piece is all about, written by James Swearingen.
Thank you.
This next melody, or pardon me, medley, is Keep Smiling Through. It's an arrangement of songs that were written during the time of the Second World War and after that, and a beautiful arrangement and really fortunate. The last piece, I'm sure Paula, she might say something about it, but if not, I just want to brag on her. She's an excellent arranger, and she arranged actually the music for the anthem, the Ukrainian anthem that we're going to do next, second on the list. So this is Keep Smiling Through. just before the end of last year in the school year. At the teacher, we kind of arranged a little fundraiser for a group that was going across to the Ukraine just to give them gifts and a little bit of money. But of course, it's so great, and there are other agencies that operated at that time too, but we wanted to get on board. And it was really cool because we had a Ukrainian flag. Actually, there was one right across the street from the school, and I thought, we need to get that thing. We need to get it in here. So I went and asked the neighbor who is across the street who has the flag, Ukrainian flag, that's hanging on their fence, if we could borrow that for a bit. And it's just to be mindful of those who are in need, right? And everybody does their part, whether it's, giving, praying, and just sending condolences where needed. But our hearts certainly go out to them. This is a Ukrainian prayer, and it was written back in the late 1800s. And it was actually written for a children's choir. And it's really neat that we get a chance to perform that.
Sure.
With the choir. And once again, Paula Quick did the arrangement with this, which I'm really proud of. This concert is going to be over before we know it. under an hour. That's wonderful. Hymn to Freedom by our very own Oscar Peterson. Oh, man. Yeah, to be able to play one of his numbers is a treat for me. And yeah, I hope you enjoy Hymn to Freedom. If you know it, feel free to sing along too. Okay, it features a choir again. Oh, that last number featured our oboist, Marty, on the oboe. Would you give her a round of applause? So thank you very much for coming. It's awesome to be able to play again, right? And to have an audience. We hope you appreciate it. We hope you tell your friends, and we want to build as a concert band and a choir. So if you've got the time, the energy to come out and to perform with us, we'd love to have you. Okay? Hymn to Freedom.
Yeah.
coming. If you feel so inclined, could you please stack chairs for us? That'll help us out. And putting them on the rack, and we'll get out of here sooner. Thank you very much again for coming out. Thank you, Bears, for reporting us. Thank you, Mitchell, for reporting us. We appreciate you guys, too. Mr. Braun, wherever you're at, we appreciate you. There he is. Yeah.